A very good evening, everyone. Welcome to our YouTube channel. So as we continue with this series of drug of the day, our today's drug is valproate. So let's get started. So valproate, as you can see, belongs to the class of anti-epileptic drugs. And to be more precise, aliphatic carboxylic acid. So valproic acid or divalproex, okay, जिनके बारे में हम आगे study करेंगे, ये दोनों इस class में आते हैं. Okay. Also, not only this, it is also present in the class for mania and bipolar disorder. Okay, along with the two other anticonvulsants, that is carbamazepine and lamotrigine. Okay, now let's go ahead. So valproate ka aage study karne se pehle, I want you to understand what is epilepsy. So epilepsy is a neurological disorder which is characterized by seizures. Now, ye seizures kya hote hai? They are basically sudden, uncontrolled electrical disturbances in the brain. Matlab, there is some abnormal electrical activity in your brain, correct? Which is responsible for seizures. Okay. Starting with it, class. It's a broad spectrum anti-epileptic drug, which is effective in all types of seizures. So don't forget this. It's a broad spectrum. Ye broad spectrum or क्यों बोलते हैं इसको और ये क्यों all types of seizures में use होता है? We'll study them. Why is it? Why is it so? Okay, so don't forget broad spectrum and it is used in all types of seizures. Fine. Now, before coming on to the mechanism of action, I want you to understand what is exactly happening in seizures. और ये seizures क्यों होते हैं? तो seizures क्या होते हैं? That there is some part in your brain जो continuously electrical impulses generate कर रहा है. Okay. It is generating those electrical impulses continuously and persistently. Okay, so जिसके वजह से वो depolarization हो रहा है आपके neurons में. So हमें क्या करना है? If you want to stop the seizures, हमें ये depolarizations को stop करना है. And how it can happen? Okay, let's get into the mechanism of action. Okay, so first depolarization रोकना है. मतलब how can we decrease the depolarization? First is by blocking the sodium channel. अगर sodium अंदर आएगा ही नहीं तो depolarization होगा नहीं. Next is inhibiting the T-type calcium channels. तो अगर मैं calcium channel को ही inhibit करती हूँ, so do you think that depolarization is possible? No. और अगर depolarization नहीं होगा, then you think that वो impulse generation or transfer होगा? No, right? So don't forget this. The whole mechanism of action, it's logical if you understand. Next is, agar aapko pata hai, there is something called as GABA and glutamate. Now, GABA, if you remember, it's an inhibitory neurotransmitter. Ye humne padha tha, right? GABA is an inhibitory neurotransmitter. Wahi agar glutamate dekhne jaye, so it's an excitatory neurotransmitter. Aur mujhe pata hai, epilepsy mein, there is this continuous impulse generation. Okay? So, मुझे इसको रोकना है. सो आई वॉन्ट एन इनहिबिटरी न्यूरोट्रांसमिटर जो ये इसको रोके. सो डोंट यू थिंक आई रिक्वायर गाबा हियर एज एन एंटी एपिलेप्टिक एक्शन? ओके, सो हाउ गाबा कैन हेल्प मी इन दिस एक्शन? फर्स्ट इज, या तो मैं गाबा का सिंथेसिस बढ़ा दू, या तो इफ आई डिक्रीज द मेटाबॉलिज्म ऑफ गाबा. ओके, सो डोंट फॉरगेट, फर्स्ट इज यू इंक्रीज द गाबा सिंथेसिस. एंड हाउ कैन यू डू दैट? If you remember this enzyme glutamic acid decarboxylase, ये enzyme क्या करता है? ये enzyme glutamate को GABA में convert करेगा. तो अगर glutamate ये क्या करेगा? Glutamate को convert करता है GABA में. So if when you stimulate this enzyme, obviously GABA का synthesis जो है वो बढ़ेगा. Okay. And which will ultimately inhibit these impulses, correct? दूसरा आता है, उसका metabolism ही रोक दो. ये जो GABA का further metabolism होगा, उसको inactivation जो होगा उसका, उसको आप रोक दो. Okay? If this inactivation of GABA, if I stop it by decreasing the metabolism, then ultimately मेरा GABA action बढ़ जाएगा. So that you can do by inhibiting this enzyme called GABA transaminase. So, ये दो एंजाइम्स को मत भूलना. ओके, सो रिमेम्बर दिस एंजाइम्स, ग्लूटामिक एसिड डीकार्बोक्सिलेज एंड गाबा ट्रांसमिनेज. ये हमने देख लिया कैल्शियम चैनल सोडियम चैनल ब्लॉक. Last is glutamine. So as I said that glutamine is an excitatory neurotransmitter. So if I want that inhibitory action, मुझे glutamate को रोकना पड़ेगा. So I want to decrease the glutamate release, right? So I hope you got the mechanism of action, sodium calcium channel inhibition, increasing the GABA action that you can do by increasing the GABA synthesis and decreasing the GABA metabolism, and then decreasing the glutamate release. Going ahead. Okay, ADR. ADR quite easy. From naam se pata chalta hai, V se vomiting, A se alopecia, L se liver damage, P se pancreatitis, R se rash, obesity, agranulocytosis, tremors and epigastric pain. Hamare in mein se at least remember alopecia, liver damage and pancreatitis. Don't forget liver damage, pancreatitis. Okay, don't forget liver damage, pancreatitis and alopecia. Ho gaya? Yes, next. Another important, fulminant hepatitis in children below 3 years. So, ye 3 years below children mein you cannot give because it is causing this fulminant hepatitis, correct? Next, coming on to the pregnancy, you cannot give during pregnancy because it causes spina bifida and neural tube defects. And isko prevent karne ke liye we give this folic acid. Why do we give this folic acid? To prevent this neural tube defects, okay? So what is spina bifida? Spina bifida ko hum split spine bhi bolte hai, which is a birth defect. Jaha pe aapka spinal cord is not developed properly. Okay, so if you can see, yaha pe bifida isse bolte, there is this two divisions which are created. Correct? Okay, don't forget spina bifida. Neural tube defects for valproate. Next, its uses. Iske uses kaafi hai. Isliye hum isko bolte hai, it is used in all types of seizures. So at least remember the sentence that it's used in all types of seizures. Most importantly, it's a drug of choice for absent seizures or petechial epilepsy. Now, ye absent seizures hote kya hai? If you see absent seizures, ye hote hai absent seizures. So basically, isme kya hota hai that a person gets blank out or he or she will continuously stare at something for a while. So absent seizures hote usme. Okay. It's also first line drug in GTCS, that is general tonic-clonic seizures and partial epilepsy. Baki sare jitne bhi hain, wo hame pata, it's used in autonic, tonic-clonic. Also, it is used in Lennox-Gastaut syndrome, infantile spasms. Also, importantly, mania bipolar, jo already humne dekha hai. Prophylaxis of migraine, very important. It's used in the prophylaxis of migraine and it's an alternative to carbamazepine in trigeminal neuralgia. So don't forget this, okay? Mania bipolar, migraine and trigeminal neuralgia. Aur yaad rakho, ye sare types of seizures bhi use hota hai. Kisme? Almost all types of seizures. So you can remember GTCS, partial, absence, autonic, Lennox-Gastaut, infantile spasm, okay? So it has this broad spectrum of action if you remember. Next, coming on to next drug-drug interaction, char drugs ke saath hai. First is carbamazepine, phenytoin, phenobarbital and lamotrigine. Okay, abhi carbamazepine ke sath kya hai ki iske ye jo hai iske active metabolite ka hydrolysis ko rokega. So agar carbamazepine ka active metabolite ka hydrolysis nahi hoga, then obviously it will result in toxicity, jiske wajah se fetal abnormalities bhi ho sakti hai. Next is phenytoin. It displaces the phenytoin from protein binding site, hence causing toxicity. Same toxicity is caused kar hai. Phenytoin ko uske protein binding se hata dega, phenytoin ki toxicity cause karega. Correct? Phenobarbital lamotrigine, uska metabolism in log ka honi nahi dega. Agar metabolism nahi hoga, then again toxicity. Just remember this drug, carbamazepine, phenytoin, phenobarbital and lamotrigine. Coming on to next. It's a potent microsomal enzyme inhibitor. Don't forget this word inhibitor, which is marked in yellow. It's very important. It's an potent enzyme inhibitor. We'll get the importance of this later on. So remember that. Its structure, if you say it's quite easy, right? So iska IPAC bhi, I think we don't want it. Hum logo ko pata chal jayega. This is number one. This is two. This is three. This is four. And then you have this is five. Okay. So you have this propanoic acid, can I say? Propanoic acid. Pentanoic acid, can I say? Sorry, pentanoic acid. Okay. Now, this second pay is carbon pay. Can I say there is this propyl group attached? Propyl group. Okay. So I think we got the IUPAC, right? We got the IUPAC. What is the IUPAC? It belongs to the aliphatic carboxylic acid. It's 2-propyl, 2-propyl pentanoic acid. Correct? Easy. Synthesis ka aur easy hai. Synthesis thoda basics mein aayega. Organic chemistry jo humne 11, 12 mein padha tha. 4-chloroheptane, if you see. This is 4-chloro and this is heptane. Okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. 7 carbon, 4-chloroheptane. When you react with this potassium cyanide, you get 4-cyanoheptane. Okay? So, kya milega hume? 4-cyanoheptane. So, hume sirf ye yaad rakhna starting. 4-chloro and KCN. Uske baad obviously chloro ke badle CN aayega. Aur hume pata hai, cyanide ka hydrolysis karke hume acid milta hai. Kya milta hai? Acid milta hai cyanide ka hydrolysis karke. And then obviously when you react it with sodium carbonate, sodium valproate milega. Easy? Okay? So, if you are enjoying this, then you can subscribe to our YouTube channel. You can press the bell notification on so you get the daily updates of all the videos that we post on this YouTube channel. Also, you can join our free WhatsApp group where we daily post the MCQs. For that, you can contact on the number given below. So, you will be directly added to the group. Continuing further. Okay, let's clear all these drawings. Divalprex. What is this Divalprex? It is a prodrug. Oh, very important. It's a prodrug. It's a semi-sodium valproate. It's called semi-sodium valproate and it's a prodrug. Next. It's a coordination compound. What is it? It's a coordination compound. So important is it's a prodrug. It's a coordination compound of valproic acid and sodium valproate in the ratio of 1:1. What it is? Coordination compound of valproic and sodium valproate in 1:1. Don't forget this. Okay. Next. It's used in mania and bipolar disorder and epilepsy as well. So, its use kya hai? Mania, bipolar disorder mein and epilepsy same hai valproate sa? Okay, fine. Then next. Iske kuch formulations or preparations are one is Depakine by Sanofi. Another is Depakon by AbbVie. Okay, Depakine by Sanofi, Depakon by AbbVie. Okay, let's go further. This is a GPAT 2019 MCQ. If you see its question, which of the following anticonvulsants have both inhibition of excitatory synapse and facilitation of GABA-mediated chloride channel opening action? Now, ye MCQ kya bol rahe hain ki do mechanisms of action usne specify kiya aur wo drug pooch rahe hain. दो है उसमें से एक है कि वो एक्साइटेटरी साइनैप्स को इनहिबिट करेगा मतलब हो सकता है कि वो ग्लूटामेट को इनहिबिट करे दूसरा है वो गाबा को फैसिलिटेट करना चाहिए तो दोनों एक्शन है अभी हमने वैल्प्रोएट पढ़ा है हमें उसके मैकेनिज्म ऑफ एक्शन पता है क्या क्या था मैकेनिज्म ऑफ एक्शन रिपीट सोडियम चैनल ब्लॉक टीटा कैल्शियम चैनल ब्लॉक गाबा सिंथेसिस को बढ़ाएगा गाबा मेटाबॉलिज्म को रोकेगा ग्लूटामेट के रिलीज को डिक्रीज करेगा करेक्ट वी हैव सीन ऑल दिस तो ग्लूटामेट वाला भी फंक्शन है इनहिबिशन का और गाबा फैसिलिटेशन का भी फंक्शन है सो आई थिंक वी नो द आंसर बट लेट्स सी द ऑप्शन ओके फर्स्ट इज फेनिटोइन सेकंड इज टोपिरामाइड थर्ड इज इथोसक्सिमाइड एंड फोर्थ इज वैल्प्रोइड सो आई होप वी गॉट द आंसर व्हाट इज द आंसर यस इट्स वैल्प्रोइड व्हाई नॉट फेनिटोइन फेनिटोइन ओनली प्रोलॉन्ग्स इनएक्टिवेटेड स्टेट ऑफ सोडियम चैनल इसका मैकेनिज्म ऑफ एक्शन सिर्फ सोडियम चैनल्स पे है नॉट बाय गाबा ओके Same, topiramate sodium channels again and decrease the glutamate activity. Iske do hai. One is by blocking the sodium channel, dusra by decreasing the glutamate activity. Okay. Next, ethosuximide. It inhibits only the T-type calcium channels. But hume chahiye the dono action, GABA bhi aur glutamate ka bhi. To wo sirf kis mein hai? Valproate mein. Fine. I hope we got it. Next MCQ. Valproic acid causes all except dash. So, क्या है जो वैल्प्रोइक एसिड कॉज नहीं करता फर्स्ट इट इज एन एंजाइम इंड्यूसर सेकेंड इट कॉजेस ओबेसिटी थर्ड इट कॉजेस हेपेटोटॉक्सिसिटी एंड फोर्थ इट कॉजेस न्यूरल ट्यूब डिफेक्ट्स ओके चलो याद करते हैं कुछ चीजें जो ऑलरेडी हमने पढ़ी है वैल्प्रोइक के एडीआर में हम लोग एल से लिवर डैमेज पढ़ा था करेक्ट ओ से ओबेसिटी पढ़ा था और न्यूरल ट्यूब डिफेक्ट जिसमें स्पाइना बाइफिडा था याद है फिर हमने फोलिक एसिड एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन किया था टू प्रिवेंट दैट ओके यहाँ पे हमने क्या पढ़ा था इट वाज एन एंजाइम इंड्यूसर और इनहिबिटर ओके क्या था इनहिबिटर था इंड्यूसर था मैंने बोला था वो येलो कलर में था मार्क्ड Remember that, very important. So yes, it was an enzyme inhibitor and not an inducer. So this is a wrong statement, correct? So what is the answer then? Let's go on to the answer. Check karte hain. Yes, answer is it's not an enzyme inducer. It's an enzyme inhibitor. So I hope you got the answer. Coming on to next MCQ, drug of choice for treatment of absence issues. Ye first hi line tha users ka, if you remember that. Drug of choice for absence. Humne bola tha absence mein. Wo stare karte rehta hai ek hi jagah pe. So that absence issues mein drug of choice kaun sa tha? Let's see the options. First, phenytoin. Second, valproate. Third, ethosuximide. And fourth, carbamazepine. Kya lagta hai? Kya hoga answer? हमने अपने ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस में पढ़ा होता है इट इज वैसे तो वैल्प्रेट सब में यूज होता है ऑल टाइप्स ऑफ सीजर बट इट वाज अ ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस फॉर जस्ट वन सीजर व्हाट वाज दैट इट वाज एब्सेंस सीजर इट्स अ ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस फॉर एब्सेंस सीजर व्हाट इज द आंसर देन वैल्प्रेट गॉट इट ओके सो होप यू लाइक द वीडियो थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग सो इफ यू लाइक द वीडियो देन डू लाइक शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब Also, if you want to know in detail about any anti-epileptic drugs and all the MCQs regarding it, then you can check on to the Elite Master Plan 3 and 4 where you get in detail information about the entire anti-epileptic drugs. Thank you.